Yesterday morning, and I was praising God, and I said, Lord, fill this house tomorrow. Let your presence be here, Lord. We want to experience your presence, God. We can't do anything without your presence. And all of a sudden, in the back of the room, I heard a song. I'm not kidding you. I heard a song, and it said, Lord, let your presence fill this place. And I said, Lord, what is that? And it got loud. I heard, let your presence, and a song was singing in the very back. You all think I'm crazy. There was a song coming from the back row back there. It said, Lord, let your presence fill this place. Just exactly what I was saying. Lord, let your presence fill this place. And I heard it so clearly. I said, what is that? Did Pam come upstairs? And I went to the back and my iPhone was on and a song I'd never heard before. I didn't touch my iPhone. I didn't turn it on and a song was playing on my iPhone. And it said, Lord, let your presence fill this place. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. I said, Lord, if that wasn't a confirmation that I was praying right. And I feel the presence of God today. Folks, we can't do anything without the presence of God. I love how you're singing this morning. I love, guys, let's just enter into worship. He is here. He's done his part. He's here. He's done all he can do. Now it's our part to enter into his presence. Amen?
Amen.
God is here to meet you today in Jesus' name.
The words to this song is before we go into it. It's the benediction from Numbers. It says, the Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. So many times when we hear those kind of words later on in the song, it says that may his favor be upon you. We get kind of an Americanized view of God's favor. This song is called The Blessing, and what his blessing is. You know, we kind of tend to think our finances, our house, our cars, the kids are good, the dogs are good. And there's some truth to that. But when you really dive down into what God was telling Moses to tell Aaron to speak over the people, the blessing is that God is with you. The blessing is the voice of God in your life. And when we, you know, when I think about the blessing, I think about seeing my children worship before the throne of God. When I think about favor being upon generations, I see legacies left by fathers and mothers. That's the blessing. I have a 90-year-old son, grandmother, and every time I see her, she tells me about how proud she is about my family. And it's not because of what we're doing, it's because that we have God in our lives, that she knows that her legacy was left to my parents, and they have left it to us. We're not perfect. But there's a favor being passed down to the generations, and it's the voice of God. So no matter what is happening in your family, you know, we're going through some things in our extended family. I encourage you to pray this song over your family this morning. And for those of you who may not know Christ, let this song be an invitation to submit to the words of the last two songs. Because you want the blessing of God. You want the voice of God in your life. And if you're wondering, if you haven't come to Christ, what's my life going to look like? What is he going to do? What is he going to, is he going to tell me to do something I don't want to do? Let me put your mind at ease. He's going to tell you stuff you don't want to do. But the blessing is that you will know that you are a straight arrow being shot by the hand of God, doing exactly what God has called you to do. I just invite you into that this morning. Thank you. Over the generations in our church.
His favor be upon you in a thousand generations, in your family, in your children, in the children, in the children. May his favor be upon you. Thank you.
for you. We adore 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 you. God, you know that we're for you. He is for you. He is for you. He is for you. He is for you. He's for you. He's for you. Oh, I know that he's for you. So it is going to happen. Hearts will be changed. Families will be brought to you.
Inmost being. You knit me together in my mother's womb. praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful. I know that full well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was made in the secret place. When I was woven together in the depths of the earth, your eyes saw my unformed body. All the days adorned for me were written in your book before one of them came to be. How precious to me are your thoughts, O God. How vast is the sum of them. Were I to count them, they would outnumber the grains of the sand. When I awake, I am still with you.
It says this: And after this I beheld, and lo, a great multitude, which no man could number, of all nations and kindreds and people and tongues, stood before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed with white robes and palms in their hands, and cried with a loud voice, saying, Salvation to our God, which sitteth upon the throne, and unto the Lamb. And all the angels stood round about the throne and about the elders and the four beasts, and fell before the throne on their faces, and worshiped God, saying, Amen. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be unto our God forever and ever. Amen. Can we sing that song again?
Children and
Worthy to be praised. We praise you, Father. We sing in agreement. Amen to you, Jesus. I just want to sing it again. May his favor be upon you in a thousand generations, in your family, your children, and the children, and the children. May his favor be upon you in a thousand generations, in your family, and your children, and the children, and the children. May his presence go before you and behind you and beside you, all around you and within you. He is with you, he is with you in the morning, in the evening, in your coming, in your going, in your weeping and rejoicing. His presence come before you.
As we sing that, as we pray that, Father, over our church and our families, Lord, we thank you for the blessing of your voice. We thank you for the presence of God within us and around us. We thank you for hearts that are washed clean and righteous only because of the blood of your Son. Amen.